The sales order, so where we got disconnected, we are discussing about the how the delivering tank is determined in the sales order. Okay. It first looks in the customer material info record. If it finds that, if it will take from there. Okay. The customer material info record is the highest priority for all the data sources. Okay. So here, because why? Because it is specific for an article. Your company might accept partial delivery for article A. Okay. Why CMIR is held important or high priority? Because it is article specific. For example, your company may allow a partial, your company may take a partial delivery for some article A, let me say ceiling guards or some other thing. Okay, whereas you don't want to take the risk of partial delivery for certain items like chemicals or other very important items. Okay, so based on the product you say, in the customer master, whether you go for allowing for partial delivery or whether you go for immediate delivery conditions, so those are very general in the customer master. But these are very specific for article in the CMIR. That is why CMIR is always held the highest priority, and it is the first source for data in our sales order. So the system first looks for the delivering plant in the CMIR. If it finds that, it takes it. Okay. And if it is not found there, then it will come to the customer master of the ship to party. Here also you have to be very specific. It's not a general customer master, it is going to be the customer master of the ship to party. If it doesn't find in both the places, it then takes the delivering plan from the material. So this is the sequence in which the system looks for the delivering plan. And this sequence cannot be changed because it is hard coded by the programming code itself. Okay. However, other than this three, you might want to define other rules. For example, for my non-priority customers, I want to deliver from so-and-so plant, which means you want to add an additional condition of groups, customer groups, or you might want to take the company or city code as a another criteria for selecting the plant. So in these cases, you can use the user exit with the help of an abacus to determine the delivering plant. Okay. So the system, once it determines the delivering plant, okay, it determines the shipping points based on that. So based on the shipping point, the system determines the route. Okay. So which means if the system doesn't determine the delivering plant, it cannot determine a shipping point. Obviously, your delivery cannot be created, okay. And Abid was saying about the availability check determining the plan. I told you it was the other way around. Because when somebody asks you, do you have sugar at home, what you will do? You will go and check in your kitchen, which means to check for availability, you need a place from where you have to check that, okay. So if the plant is not determined, then the system cannot carry out an availability check and it can't confirm any quantities. That is realistically, whether it is available or not, it cannot confirm. Instead, it can confirm whatever quantity you enter with a delivery date, even though the physical quantity is not there. So that is why determining the shipping delivering plant is the most important and first step in our delivery process. Then we come to the shipping point. Did we see these definitions in our first enterprise structure class? Okay. So now, based on the delivering plan, the system will determine a shipping point. Okay. How the system determines the shipping point? Because it takes the shipping, I mean the delivering plant plus shipping conditions plus loading group of the material. So let us go to IMG. So hereafter, for a while we don't have any work with the sales and distribution node. So we will be seeing the, we are going to execute the logistics. So logistics execution node. Shipping, basic shipping function, shipping points and goods determination, goods receiving point determination. Okay. So, this shipping conditions you define saying that, okay, whether it is urgent or standard or as soon as possible, so these kind of things. Okay. So, SAP provides with the standard one, but other than this, if you want to create based on your company naming convention, you can create that. Here it is just a name, that's it. Okay. It doesn't have any other controls associated with that. Okay. So it is 0102. Okay. Normally the shipping conditions are proposed from the customer master. Okay. However, you can give shipping conditions for the document types also. If you had given the shipping conditions in the document type, the system overrides the customer shipping condition checking in the customer master and takes the shipping conditions of the document type. This example we can see with the cash sales document type. For example, in the cash sales slash OVOV8, okay, our cash sales document type is BVRCS. The shipping condition is checked as immediately. So that is what, yeah. So in the document type, so that is why when you create, I mean, in the customer level, even though whatever it is there, since the shipping condition is immediate in the document type, the system takes this and creates the document immediately, I mean delivery immediately. So shipping condition is proposed in the customer master, but if it exists in the document type, it is overridden by that. Okay. So then we come to the shipping condition. Okay, so shipping condition is just a two-letter entry, which is helpful in determining your shipping point. Other than that, it doesn't have any control. Okay. And we have something called as loading group. So loading groups means, so there are certain articles which could be loaded by, which could be loaded manually, loaded into the truck basically. Okay. There are some articles which could be loaded only by using the forklift. Sometimes some things need the overhead crane. Not all the shipping points have the overhead cranes or forklift. Okay. Some, because overhead cranes are huge in structure, of, I mean, that construction will be, so that is why like not all the shipping points have that overhead crane. So if you feel like your article must be handled with only with that overhead crane, then this decision influences the determination of shipping point, because you have to handle the goods only in the shipping point which has the overhead crane. So based on these parameters, so we had come to know that the delivery plant plus shipping condition plus loading group determines the shipping point. For example, in our case, our delivering plant is 1200. Let me go to the sales order here. In my sales order, the delivering plant is determined as 1200. Shipping condition is proposed from the customer or the document type. So you can find them only in the header part. Okay, so let us see what is there in the, okay. So I go to header. shipping. Shipping price is standard. Okay. Then we have to find out the loading group of this material. So what is the material? AT101. Okay. Loading group can be found in the general plant data, A102. Now plant is 1200, 1010. Here I can find the loading group as well as transportation group. Transportation group says how it has to be transported, whether it can be done in pallets or it has to be done via containers or it has to be done via break bulk port, which means there is no packing, you can just stuff it into the containers just like that. This mostly is done with the grains, food grains, okay. So how it has to be, not food grains, okay, sorry. It is normally done in case of coal, iron ores, etc. Because they are not packed and transported. They are just dumped into the container. Okay, that is the break bulk mode. And which mode it has to be is the transportation group. And how it will be handled is the loading group. So in this case, the loading group is 003. My shipping condition is 01 and the delivering plant is 1200. So based on this combination, the system is, we are going to determine the delivering plant. Unfortunately, here there is no position button where you can search for that. 02. 03. Okay, so this is the combination. For 03, for plant 1200, the system automatically proposes 1200. However, if you want to override any selection, and we have seen that a plant can be assigned to many shipping points and many shipping, okay, and the other way around. Okay, so if you want to the system to use other shipping points if something is not possible, or if you feel that there will be a delay in this particular plant, if you want to do use the other plants, then you have to enter them here. For example, let me say I want the system to choose 1200 first. If it is not possible, then it can use the 1400, okay, and 2000. Okay, the assignment has to be made. It is not made. So I can propose the alternate shipping points in case of if I couldn't use the main shipping point. Okay. Shipping point is an independent unit. It is one company code. Yeah, correct. Okay, but we are talking about shipping point, not the plant. No, I am not assigning the plant. See, the plant, here the plant names and the shipping point names are maintained identical. That is how you got the confusion. The shipping point is separate. So in the enterprise structure you can see that. For example, I go to the enterprise structure, assignment, logistics execution, assign shipping point to plant. Okay. Here I must have maintained before that. Okay, for example, let me scroll down, what is for my plant number 1200. Okay. What are things I have? 199. If I want to assign for this plant, if I want to assign another shipping point, I can select this. I go to assign. Okay, I want to take 1300, 1400. Okay, I had assigned. So that I can use these shipping points for that particular plant. Here I have made it now. Okay, now if I go back to my logic execution, here now I can assign the shipping points. For example, so let me scroll down to shipping condition. In some cases, they had maintained the alternate plan. So similarly, we can also do that. For my I'm looking for the 01003 combination. Okay, for 01003. 1200. Now I had added 1300 and 1400. Other than that, I had yes 001, yes 002. The system will take all these things. Similarly, I go to shipping condition 02. Loading group is 003. So other than that, I want to add 1300, 1400, S001, S002. Okay. Let me come out of the sales order because I want the system to refresh the database. VA01 go on VA8101. I need only one piece, no problem. We'll go to shipping. Okay, by default the system has proposed, but you can see it can be overwritten. If I choose F4, I can get the charges. Okay, what is the condition? I have to maintain. Okay, we'll come to that later. So, based on the shipping delivering plan, the system determines the shipping point. Now the shipping point has been determined. Now you have to find out in which route this is the delivery is going to be taken place. Okay, route is, even the route is sounds important, many of the companies, they don't take route as a they don't let the system to take decisions on route. Instead, they plan the route based on the transportation facilities and the transportation providers. Okay, however, SAP had given the provision of determining a route automatically. Yes. So to determine the route, let us go to the logistics execution again. Come to route. Yes. Route determination. Okay. So we have something called as transportation zone. If I go to the customer master, where is the customer master? /NBD02. You can see there is a transportation zone in the general data. Okay, this transportation zone says, okay, which this transportation zone is completely, company dependent. Company dependent in the sense like it doesn't reflect your political segregation of your country or city. Nothing like that. Okay, for your convenience, you are dividing a city or a region into so many transportation zones. Okay, and this transportation zone is entered in the customer master. Okay, so that is one criteria in determining the route, and another one is the transportation groups which we saw right now. Okay, so in the material master, okay, when we say that I am creating my delivery based on shipping point, the shipping point is also a physical location and it must also lie in some country and a transportation zone. So here you can maintain the country and transportation zone for the shipping point. In our case, our shipping point was 1200. Okay, so we will see what is the transportation zone it has been assigned to. Our shipping point was 1200. Okay, so it lies in the country Germany DE and it lies in the region DE0. Okay, that is region Dresden. Okay, so now we had found the destination transportation zone, that is the transportation zone of the customer, and we have now known the transportation zone of the plant, that is the shipping point, that is the origin transportation zone. And we have the transportation groups that is taken from our material master, and we have found the shipping conditions from the customer master or the document type. So based on this combination, we are going to determine the routes. Okay, I go to main route determination. Okay, so when you are creating determining the route, there are two types. One is taking the weight into consideration or not taking the weight into consideration. There is certain things like, okay, by default the system can propose a airway route, but your weight is so much, okay, which will be consuming, let me say, 3 containers or something. Okay, even though the system has proposed as air, if you take weight into consideration, you cannot lift it by air. Instead, you have to go for sea route only. Okay, so that is why there are two options. One is without weight group and with weight group. But in real time scenario, most of the time we handle with the without weight group. Okay, so let me go to the without weight group order. Okay, in my case, both the departure zone as well as the destination zone are the shipping point is 1200. Country of departure is DE. Okay. So before that, let me see what is the customer details. The customer, okay, is D0060. Okay. So I go to the route determination. The plant lies in this zone. Okay. Similarly, destination country, that is the this one. Okay. I don't want to. Weight not taken into consideration, that is on some special scenarios, okay, not all the time. Okay, so that is what I say. So by default you say like, okay, for this combination I might want to take it in here. So let me say your customer says send it immediately or urgently or on high priority. Okay, when you hear the word urgently or on high priority, the first thing that comes to your mind is the air, because that is the quickest form of transportation. Okay, but the quantity will be so large. Okay, in this case, even though you might want to lift it by air, considering the quantity, that is the weight, you might have to go for sea. Okay, this is the scenario normally. Yeah, you can maintain with that. So you will see that. Okay. So for this departure zone and for this receiving zone. Okay. Nice. So based on the shipping conditions and the transportation zone, our first standard, okay, for the transportation group 001 we saw in the material master. That is how the system determines route R00130. Okay, is it clear? So let us see what happens when the weight group is considered. Okay. With weight group. So for this combination with weight group, okay, setting is entered. So I can maintain a new entry. Okay, my shipping condition is 02, that is standard. My transportation group was 0001. Okay, I have to find out the weight group. Weight group is says okay, more than 100 kgs, over 100 kgs. Okay, then instead of R 00130, I might want to use R131 or something else. Is 131 available? Okay, I might want to use something else. Okay, this is how. For the same starting point, same destination point, for the same shipping condition, transportation group, okay. But if I don't consider the weight group, the system will propose R130. But if I consider the weight group, the system is going to propose 34. Okay, this is the way you can differentiate or you can maintain different routes by considering the weight. Okay, is it clear? Okay, fine. So now in our sales order, we had determined, we had found out how the system determines the delivering plant, how the shipping point is determined, then how the routes are determined. Okay. So this is a very basic point in creating the delivery. And we have seen the deliveries are created for shipping points. Okay. So in your article, in your order, if you have more than one, let me say, if you have more than one item and if the items differ by shipping points, for example, and one thing, we'll show that in action also. Okay. So, let us go to the shipping point determination. Okay. Same shipping points. Okay. My shipping condition was 02. Let me check with the customer what is that shipping condition. Go to sales area data. My shipping condition is 02. Okay. For 02, my loading group is 003. Shipping condition 02, loading group 003, and the delivering plan 1200. There are so many plans, delivering plans, sorry, shipping points assigned. Okay. So let me go to the sales order slash N VA01 over. Go to the shipping point. Okay. Let me see. Okay. So for one article, I am taking the 1200 as the default shipping point. So let me add another article, T-AT102, another 10 pieces. Okay. But I want the delivery to be from some other shipping point. Okay. 1300. Okay. Even though here the plants are same, based on some conditions, okay, the conditions we have seen, the shipping points are created separately. Okay. So if we try to create a delivery for this, the system is going to create a delivery split because the shipping points were different. Okay. 11821. Now I am going to create a delivery slash n el 01 n. The first point or parameter based on which the delivery is being created is the shipping point. So in our case, for the same sales order, we have two shipping points. Okay, so if I give 1200, the system will take only the item that had the 1200 as its shipping point. So we are going to have two deliveries for that, for two different shipping points. Okay. No, for different items. Okay. See, for 8101, there is one delivery. Okay. And for the same sales order, for 8102, because the 8102 is being shipped from the 1300. Okay. This currently has to be very short. So the L01M. Okay. If I see the document flow, I can see that 0 and the sales order is partially delivered and we have got one subsequent delivery for the sales order. Okay. The standard order is being processed. So now I can give it for delivery. I can go this way also. Instead of going to the transaction or through the menu path, I can open the sales order. From the sales order, I can go to the deliver directly. So I go to the, since first one is delivered, it is grayed out. You cannot change the article number, anything under. However, you can change the quantity. Okay. So let me go to the deliver for the remaining pieces. If I go to the header, since it is in the header level, okay, so you can find the shipment functionality. So from where it is being, the shipping point is 1300 and it has got a different route because it has got a different shipping point. So based on the shipping point and the other parameters like your shipping condition, starting zone and destination zone, the system has determined a different route. Okay. So this is how your, this is the basics of your delivery. Okay. Tomorrow we will see, I mean like in real time scenario, it's highly impossible that you will be creating a delivery separately for the sales order because on an average day, you will be creating hundreds and sometimes even thousands of sales orders. Okay. So it is impossible to process all these sales orders manually by going to VL01N or going through that menu path. Instead, tomorrow we will see something called as collective processing, which means like for that I need many open sales orders. So I want you people to create at least 5 sales orders each. Okay, 5 sales orders, but don't do any delivery. You just create the sales orders and note down the order numbers. Okay, tomorrow we will see the collective processing. Okay. Yeah. Any other document type is possible, because the criteria is only based on the shipping point and the date, not on the. However, I mean, if you want to create, okay, I want to finish the deliveries of all the sales orders, standard orders, then you can do that. Okay, but by default it is like only based on the shipping point and the delivery date. So you can use your document type also. Not necessary. No. The articles use the articles AT101 up to AT105. Okay. These are maintained for the same plant. Okay. This is the standard teaching article. Okay. So these are maintained for the same plant. So you will be getting the same plant and same shipping point only. Okay. So, however, you can, for a couple of sales orders, you can manually overwrite this shipping point, shipping point with 1300 or something else. Okay. And just 5 each, that's enough. So, I expect 5 from Teresa and 5 from you. Okay. Type down the number. Okay. If possible, just name it to me so that we can use it in the tomorrow's class. Okay. Number of the orders, sales orders. Okay. I'll catch up tomorrow. I hope there won't be any break like today. Okay. See you. Thank you. Bye.